Sitting down with Maysville former head girls coach Pat Miller this afternoon. I'm Aaron Sprague with Storied Rivals. This is Pat Miller, 18 years as the head coach of the Big Cats of the Maysville girls basketball program. And coach, really wanted to sit down and just kind of have a chat with you. They don't make them like you anymore. You know, longevity, right? You know, you lasted 18 years. You had a good bit of success, but you're stepping away. So the first question is, why is the timing right for you now to go off into the sunset and enjoy the next chapter of your life?
I'm just ready. I mean, I'm just tired. I've, you know, been doing this for 20 years with the girls program, two as an assistant. It's just time. I mean, I'm ready for a break.
Right. Did you ever think you'd last this long? I mean, when you took the job back in 2003, did you think that you would still be doing this long, or what part of it triggered it to kind of get the juices flowing where you really enjoyed it?
You know, the thing about it is, the reason I thought I would be doing it this long is because of Bailee. Bailee and me made a pinky promise when she was just a little girl, and she made me promise her that I'd coach her all the way through. So, you know, it's kind of been the running joke that, you know, this is when I was going to go.
That's a pretty cool story.
Yeah.
You know, because I remember Bailee when she was young, little Smitty, had the jersey on.
Yep.
And she was the chest bump girl, and all the girls picked her up running for the starting lineups. And you got to figure someone that's around the program that much, she was going to be pretty good, right?
Absolutely.
And it turned out well. The MBL girls all-time leading scorer, All-Ohio, scholarship player at West Liberty. So that's a pretty cool story that kept you going, right? That little promise. And she did her part to make you keep you guys pretty good the last few years.
She did. She wrote me a really good note. And I mean, I was in tears and everything else about it. And yeah, it's a pretty good story.
That's awesome. That's really cool. And her whole family came through. And you've had a great coaching staff. You know, Troy Valley and Brian Smith have stuck with you throughout. So you guys have had the guy time as well as coaching time. So that'd be fun coaching with
Absolutely.
Your friends. They've done a great job.
Yeah, and that's one of the things I told them last night that I'd probably miss more than anything is just, you know, hanging out with them guys and going scouting, because we had a great time when we did those kinds of things.
Now, when did you really start loving it? Because we were talking, and you know, you used to be the baseball coach. You've kind of done everything as you were a younger guy. And then you settled in as the face of the girls' basketball program, really one of the pillars of the MVL in the East District. At what point did you really start getting into it where you really became a girls' basketball coach?
I would say it was probably after my first year as the head coach. I mean, like I said, I was an assistant with Coach Vaughn for 2 years. And, you know, I was trying to coach football. I was trying to coach, you know, I was a head baseball coach. But after the first year, I just figured it out that I couldn't do it all. And, you know, I had your wife my second year, first and second year. And I mean, I just figured, you know, I enjoyed it.
Well, and you evolved with the game, you know, and with the players you had. You know, when my wife played in your early years, you guys were like everybody else. You had some post players. You ran it kind of slow. You fed the post. You had a couple players that could score, where you evolved into your most successful seasons, where it was run as fast as we can, score as much as we can. Talk about that progression of your program and really girls basketball as a whole, where the post became almost a lost art. And now it was a goal of how good of athletes can we have to put the ball in the basket?
Well, you know, I think, you know, what evolved was is, you know, the more players we had, the more success we had, the more all the little kids were coming around. And, you know, they'd come to summer camps, they would, you know, see how we played, and they started playing like that. I mean, and we didn't have the post players.
That's
so
right.
So everything just became, you know, play as hard as you can on defense, let's get some easy buckets, get down, run what we can, try to score as quick as we can. And that's kind of what we did.
Well, and it worked. I mean, to the tune of seven MVL titles, four district titles. From what I could find, almost 350 career wins for yourself, you know, winning percentage near 80% throughout. You had seven 20-win seasons, I think 12 seasons of 18 wins or more. So it worked.
It worked.
It worked.
Yeah.
Tell me about the grind of being a head coach, especially one that's trying to be successful and to win those championships. What is the grind like trying to be an educator than trying to be a coach of young ladies?
Well, the hardest thing is with basketball is watching all the film you watch, trying to come up with something for, you know, the better teams, trying to keep them up. I mean, we had one period, we was just talking about this last night, we had a 62-game regular season winning streak.
Yeah, wow.
So, I mean, for my kids to come in and night after night after night, you know, keep that thing going, we never talked about it. We never talked about, this is, you know, Same old story. We never talked about it until, guess what? We got beat. And yeah. We talked about it the night before we got beat.
Did you really?
Yes. And that was the only time we ever talked about it.
And what game? What was the game
that
you lost?
That was the Philo game. Philo game and... Jeezy. I don't know. I just remember it was Philo.
So it got in your head a little bit.
It kind of did. That was towards the end of the year. So, I mean, yeah.
So you had that run of success. So you had four straight MVL titles. Then you had five out of 6 years there in the mid-2000s. What was it, like 12 to 16, 12 to 15 around there?
I want to say that, yeah.
So I think you won 2011. Then it was 13, 14, 15, 16.
16
so
and the, 18.
It, there you go. So yeah. Well, seven total.
Yep.
So heck of a run. What was your most memorable win, you think?
Wow.
I mean, one that it just gets you. That you're going to forget a lot of the wins, but there's a few you're not going to forget.
The most memorable win I just remember, there was a couple. Both of them was against Riverview. Riverview was ranked fourth in the state, and I think this was my daughter's senior year, 2008. They were ranked like fourth in the state, and we beat them in the sectional championship. We beat them the first game of the year and they never lost.
Oh, I remember that. Yeah.
They never lost the rest of the year. And we went back in and played them for the sectionals. They were the higher seed, of course. And everybody said, "You're crazy. Why are you going in there for?" Well, our girls had the confidence and they wanted to go play them. And it worked out.
Yeah, and there were some big ones. I mean, you know, the district titles. Tell me about the first district title and how that may have compared to the ones later in your career where you had done it before. How did those compare? I guess for you emotionally or, you know, as a coach?
I guess the first one was with, you know, Rachel Portman and Ashley Love. And, you know, I just remember, you know, we'd won the sectional, and that was the first sectional we won the year before. And then, you know, the girls just played so well. I mean, Rachel's one of my all-time favorites, probably one of the best players that's ever played for
sure.
Me. And, you know, she made everybody else around her better. And Ashley, you know, we always, you know, made a comment that Ashley played in the post, but she played like a boy. And the reason she played like a boy is because she played against boys. And that's what made her a really good player, too. And, you know, I just enjoy those times. But like I said, probably in 2008 when we won the district, we weren't expecting to win the district because we went from Division III up to Division II.
Yeah.
And we lost Rachel and Ashley. So, I mean, that was, you know, that was a nice one, too. And then... the other ones with, you know, Brooke and Cappy and Callie and all them. I mean, that was just a team that just got along so well and played so hard. And, you know, they just knew when they took the court they were going to win.
Yeah, that was a talented team. In fact, I'll put you on the spot here for a second. Was that the best team you ever coached? Because in my opinion, I thought that team had the tools to go all the way. That particular year when Brooke Smith and Callie Tapman were seniors.
Yeah. Well... see, I thought the year before we were better than that when we had Kayla Russell.
Well, it helps to have, yeah, even more experience.
Yeah. So, but yeah, but you got to remember something. In that regional final, I'll never forget, we didn't score in the first quarter.
Yeah.
And that just killed us because we fought our way back and actually took the lead in the fourth quarter, but we were just out of gas.
Right.
We had to come out.
Well, which is crazy because those teams were the epitome of run and gun. When you watched them play, it was... We can't hold this team under 30.
Yeah.
So, does that still baffle you that
it still
you
baffles me? Yes.
Slowed down.
Yes. I mean, don't get me wrong. West Ames is a great defensive team. We knew that going in, but to shut us out in the quarter, I mean, that just stunned us.
It did.
But to the girls' credit, I mean, they fought back. They never gave up.
They did. I mean, I guess we could talk about it now that it's over, but you're probably never going to get over is West Holmes. I mean, they happen to have one of their best pro years ever when you guys were as good as you could be, and they got one state title out of it, four Final Fours, and you guys are left on the doorstep. I mean, how much does that, you know, when you think about your career, how much does that bother you that, man, like that one stretch, we had such good teams, and it was just the one team that got us.
It bothers me for the kids more than it does
me. Oh, of course.
Because, you know, I mean, the kids just, that was a group of kids, like you said, that, you know, just worked their butts off.
Yeah.
And they wanted to be good. And there was no stopping them until we ran the West Ames.
Yeah, just that one roadblock, man.
Yeah. But I'll tell you what was exciting about that. Both years we sold out Zanesville's gym.
For sure.
Their new gym.
Yeah.
I mean, the first year especially because they oversold it and wall to wall back in the corners. I mean, it was they had to clear the floor, you know, area so we could get out on the floor. I mean, that's something.
It was. I mean, that was a great time. Again, we mentioned great teams, great tournament runs, four district titles, tough regional losses, but you experienced so much.
Yeah.
Best player you've ever coached is easy. Bailee made that easy, right?
Did,
you've coached
yes.
some good ones.
Yes, I have.
And you look back at your championship teams, you've been blessed, and you'll say this, with pretty good talent all the way through.
Usually
one of the league's top players every time.
Yeah, I mean, I have been blessed with really good players. I mean, Corey Sidwell comes to mind.
Yeah,
I mean, you know, you can sit there and name them, Rachel, Melanie, just on and on. Even though, I mean, Kayla Russell never got 1,000 points, but she was one of the better players. She was one of the better shooters. And then, I mean, look, Brooke, she was a 1,000-point scorer. She could play defense. I mean, she was one of the better players, too. The list just goes on and on.
It is a long list.
It is.
Man. So win it the way you did. And people forget. I mean, people always remember, like, now, right? So now you have Sheridan and Tri-Valley. The last few years have been good. But we talked about that five-year stretch where you were beating everyone and beating them pretty bad. I mean, everything goes in cycles. And, man, you really were part of, you could almost say, a dynasty during that time period where you were the talk of the East District and you had the athletes to back it up.
Yeah, we were pretty good.
Right? That was fun. It's always fun when you win.
Yeah,
so what are you going to miss most, you know, about being in this locker room and game days? Because it's going to hit you next winter when you're not coaching.
I just miss the competition. I really do. I enjoy competition. I've always enjoyed competition. Back when I played, I enjoyed competition. And, it's, you know, I tell the girls, so much is the emphasis with people now is not winning.
Sure.
I think winning is very important. I'm sorry. You know, I always give the example, you're going out for a job, you know, there's only one shot. Do you want to lose? I mean, you don't want,
right.
If it's your dream job, do you want to lose?
You're right. Winning is underrated at sometimes.
Sometimes it
gets pushed to the side, but winning fixes a lot of problems.
It does.
You know?
It sure does. Yeah.
You know, when you come out on top. I guess, you know, as we wrap up here, a couple of final things. Do you have any regrets at all? Any games you could have back or any moments or, you know, I'm sure there might be a couple, but I mean, anything that really sticks out in your mind where you're like, man, I could have did this or just anything that's going to bug you as you walk away?
No, there really is not. I mean, I'm happy with
way
everything went. I mean, there's one game that if I could take back, we sold out this place here, us and West's game in 2007. We lost that game. And on the last second shot, I mean.
So that one sticks out.
That kind of sticks out, yeah. But also the regional final games. But other than that, no, I don't have any regrets.
All right, really now you were a master of working the sidelines. The water bottle, the slam of the water bottle.
Yeah.
You worked some East District officials in your time. Are you gonna miss any of those guys? And then that banner back and forth, I'm not sure if they're gonna miss you though.
Yeah, I don't know. I've calmed down though last few years. So, yeah, hopefully we've made up enough to where, you know, they'll at least talk to me when they see me. But now I enjoyed all them guys too. And it's, you know, I told them once, I said, you know, I argued a lot of calls, but I said, once I go back and I watch film, yeah, I see what you
right.
saw.
Yeah,
so, I mean, you know, they know how I
Well, you got to work it. You got to.
Absolutely,
you
know, yes.
You got to try to even it out.
It might get you some calls. I mean, you know.
For sure.
Yeah.
How do you, you know, final question. How do you, and not that this is not the type of person you are at all, but how do you want to be remembered, you think? I mean, because you were the longest tenured coach here at Maysville. You did set the standard for success. How do you want people to look back on this program someday and kind of look at what was done here during that 18-year stretch?
I just want to know that I cared about their daughters. That's it.
Sure.
That's the only thing.
Absolutely.
That's it.
Well, congratulations on a great career. Enjoy the golf course.
Yeah,
and,
I will.
And enjoy some rest and take a game in where you can just kind of chill and cheer.
I will do that.
All right, that's Pat Miller, former head coach of the Maysville Panthers, 18 years, 7 MVL titles. Time for a new guy to take the reins. I'm Aaron with Storied Rivals. Thanks for watching.